Hey guys, welcome to Pursuit Kids Online. We are so excited that you're joining us this morning. I'm Miss Irene.
And I'm Miss Carrie, and it's my most favorite time of the day. It's time to worship. So get ready to stand to your feet, get ready to lift your hands and dance with us, because worship starts now.
I'm crazy, good thing they're not. forgiven, accepted, redeemed by His grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise. 'Cause we were the beggars, now we're royalty. We were the prisoners, now we're running free. We are forgiven, accepted, redeemed by His grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise.
There's joy in the house.
There is joy in this house.
There's joy in the house of the Lord today.
Hey preschoolers, this week we're going to learn about the growing friendship of David and Jonathan. So get ready because your video starts now.
It's Kelly!
Hey!
What we gonna do today? We're gonna learn and play.
Okay.
Sing a song and pray.
That's right.
God really loves us. God really, really cares about you, me, our families.
That's right.
God's always right there.
You've got this. Okay, friends, you might be wondering why your friend Callie is pacing in her room with a pair of drumsticks. Let's press rewind. The last time we were together, I, Callie Ferguson, was going to become a rock star for Jesus by learning how to play the drums, the most rocking instrument of all. It turned out to be a bit harder than I thought to play the drums, but I've been practicing, as you can see. Well, my mom and dad sometimes sing at church, and when the music leader at church heard I was learning to play the drums, they asked me to play on stage in front of people! It's okay. I just have to play the simple beat. It goes... Oh, no! Or is it... No! No! It's for sure! Or is it... Ugh! I have to play at church on stage in front of people this weekend! And now I can't even remember which beat I'm supposed to play! Oh no, oh no!
Whoa! Callie, what's wrong?
Nothing.
I just heard you were playing drums with us this Sunday at church. I'll be rocking in the band too. Rocking the ukulele.
Oh, great!
It doesn't sound great. What's wrong?
Well, it's just that I'm scared. I haven't been playing the drums very long, and now I can't even remember the beat I'm supposed to play.
Callie, it's okay to be scared. I get it. I was scared the first time I played the ukulele and sang in front of people too.
You were?
Totally.
Well, what did you do?
Well, I'd be happy to tell you all about it, but let's see what our Bible story has to say.
It's time for today's Bible story, and it comes from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 16 and 18. King Saul had disobeyed God, so Saul wasn't going to be king for much longer. But he was still king for now, and sometimes he got grumpy, like really grumpy. So Saul asked David to come and play the harp for him. When David played the harp, it comforted Saul, and it helped him feel better. So David came to live with the king. David became best friends with Saul's son, Jonathan. Jonathan loved his friend very much. Jonathan gave David many things like his own robe and clothes, even his sword. David continued to serve King Saul and do everything Saul asked him to do. David was very good at his job, so Saul even gave David a high rank in the army. This meant David had a lot of power in the army. But one day, when they were coming back from the battle, the people sang about how David killed more men than Saul did. Saul didn't like this. He became so jealous and angry that one day David was playing the harp for Saul and Saul threw a spear at David 2 times. Thankfully, David was able to get away. After that, Saul sent David away from him. But David continued to do well in everything he did because God was with him. God used David to comfort King Saul by playing the harp. When David was the one who needed comfort, God was with David and gave him comfort in his friend Jonathan. There will be moments when you are afraid. In those moments, we can know that God is with us and will give us comfort. So when you're afraid, you can say, God, you comfort me when I'm afraid.
Callie, did that make you feel better?
Actually, yeah, kind of. I mean, no matter what happens, I don't think anyone will throw spears at me like Saul did at David. Wowzers, that would be really scary.
Right, but God gave David Jonathan to comfort him. Maybe it sounded like this. That's what happened with me. I was scared the first time I played a ukulele on stage. My fingers were shaking, but then my friends in the band reminded me that they were right there with me. They would love me no matter what happened. That made me feel really good. Then I rocked the ukulele and sang like nobody was looking. It was so much fun. Callie, I'll be right there with you this weekend at church. No matter what beat you play, I'll still love you. God gives us each other when we feel scared, so that we can say, God, you comfort me when I'm afraid.
That makes me feel like rocking.
See, Callie, you're gonna do awesome. Can't wait. See you soon.
Friends, have you ever been scared to do something or of something? Look around you. Maybe God has given you someone like God gave Jonathan to David. God gave us those people for a reason, so that we can say, God, you comfort me when I'm afraid. Thanks so much for learning and growing with me, friends. Peace out!
Hey guys, today in elementary, we're gonna talk about how God comforts us when we're afraid. So get ready, because your video starts now.
Emma, I was in a band once.
Yeah, you told me. The boy band, Equally Bad.
Oh, no. After that, I was in another band, an instrumental band called Strings and Things.
Ooh, that sounds cool. Violins, cellos, guitars, stuff like that.
Oh, yeah. That would have been cool. We just tied strings to things and went, bing, 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 bing. And I'm Jay. Welcome to Press Play.
The last couple times we hit play, Jay and I have been in a band called Emma and the Stray Cats. Grandma's cats are our backup dancers.
We just had our first show and it went great.
Jay, I was thinking, I feel kind of bad that it's Emma and the Stray Cats. If we do another show, maybe you could be the lead singer. Jay and the Stray Cats.
For real?
Yeah, I'll sing backup for you anytime.
Oh, wow. Thanks, Emma. Okay, if I'm gonna do this, I'll have to go through all my vocal warm-ups, all of them.
Okay, I'll do it with you.
Are you sure?
Yeah, absolutely, bud, why not?
Okay, first say, my mommy made me mash my M&Ms.
My mommy made me mash my M&Ms.
Faster, my mommy made me mash my M&Ms.
My mommy made me mash my M&Ms.
Faster, my mommy made me mash my M&Ms.
My mommy made me mash my M&Ms.
Faster, my mommy made me mash my M&Ms.
Jay, I think we're good on that one.
Oh, okay. Next, I open my mouth as wide as possible and stick my tongue out. Then I scream like a crazed rabbit baboon. As such. Now you go.
Let's just get going. 3, 2, 1, press play! Whoa!
Are we in space?
I think so. Looks like we're on a whole nother planet.
But we're not floating away or anything.
That's correct. This planet has gravity, Cadet.
Coach Pug!
Our old coach from online space camp. So great to see you. What are you doing here?
Well, I talked with your grandma. Sweet lady. Lots of cats. She was all this business with me. And we ended up nailing down a gig for Emma and the Stray Cats at the biggest venue in the galaxy.
That is awesome. Except for this show, it's going to be Jay and the Stray Cats. I'll be singing backup this time. Right, Jay?
Yeah. Right. I guess. Unique New York, unique New York. No, need unique New York. Unique New York. It's, how many New Yorks? New York, unique. You need unique. I think I'm messing it up.
Oh, Jay, what's up, buddy?
Yeah, Cadet, I've never seen you like this. What's going on?
It's just, how many people will be at the show?
People? Let me see here. 1 million, okay? People, aliens, creatures of all kinds. So if you add all that, probably 3.5 million, easily.
Well, that's just wonderful.
Jay, are you scared?
Well, that depends. My socks are soggy with sweat. My heart is beating so hard I can barely even hear anything else. And my mouth is so dry, it feels like the Sahara Desert. Yes, I think I'm scared.
Well, here you go, Cadet. Oh. It's okay to be scared. All right? We're here for you. Why, even the great King David from the Bible had to deal with fear.
Really?
Oh, yeah. In the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 16 and 18, Samuel had anointed David as king at God's direction. But David wasn't king yet. Saul was still the guy for a while longer. But the Bible says he was extremely unwell and he had trouble sleeping. It was so bad that Saul's servant wanted to find someone who could play the lyre. That's a stringed instrument.
Well, Coach Pog, I was in this band called Strings and Things.
Not the time, Jay.
Oh, right.
Anyway, what do you know? The person they found to play that stringed instrument was David. So David would play the lyre for Saul, and for a while, Saul liked David. But let me tell you, that would soon change. David was growing in fame. Everything he did went well. And whenever he went to battle, let's just say, he won. David even became BFFs with Saul's own son, Jonathan. It was all well and good until one day when the Israelites were celebrating a victory, King Saul overheard them singing in 1 Samuel 18:7. Saul has slain his thousands and David his tens of thousands. Saul was jealous of David, and he was angry, so angry, that as David was playing the lyre one day, Saul threw a spear at him. Oh. David ran for it. Can you imagine? Oh. David was far from his hometown of Bethlehem, and now the king himself wanted to kill him. But David was able to find comfort in his best friend, Jonathan, who pledged his loyalty to David. And God reminded David that through every victory, God was always with him and would never leave him. The same is true for you, Cadet.
What do you say, Jay? Ready to do this? Crowd's waiting.
Oh, yeah. I forgot to tell you. Out here, space concerts are very short. In fact, they're usually like 10 seconds.
What? I can do that. And I know just what to sing.
You got this.
God, you're with me when I'm weak. God, you comfort me when I'm afraid. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, the big idea alarm.
Great job, Jay. Everyone, join us for the secret press play handshake.
I can't believe I sang in front of 3.5 million people, aliens, and creatures.
You really did, buddy. You did so good.
You know, it must have been my baboon scream.
Yeah, I think it was. Let's recap. We press play and we're at the biggest gig in the galaxy. Coach Pog was there and helped Jay through some stage fright by sharing the story of David being afraid of King Saul in 1 Samuel 16 and 18. David was scared, but God gave him comfort by being close to him and giving him friends like Jonathan. How has God given you comfort when you were afraid? Now you know what time it is. Time to
drop the verse.
Oh. I can't wait to drop this verse.
Oh, if you got a harp, get it out now.
Get it out right now if you got a harp. Here we go. Sing to the Lord with grateful praise. Make music to our God on the harp. Psalm 147, 7. Psalm 147, 7. Sing to the Lord with grateful praise. Make music to our God on the harp. Psalm 147, 7. Psalm 147, 7. Sing to the Lord with grateful praise. Make music to our God on the harp.
Psalm 147,
7.
Psalm 147,
7. Sing to the Lord with grateful praise. Make music to our God on the harp.
Hey guys, I hope you had so much fun worshiping with us that you learned something new from your Bible stories.
Yes, and don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any updates from Pursuit Kids Online. We love you guys and we'll see you next week.
Bye guys.